We talked already how to subtract mixed numbers with the same denominators. What about subtracting mixed numbers with different denominators? How much is 2 2/3 minus 1 1/2? In this case, we also have to represent each fraction as an improper fraction. Let's start with 2 2/3. Here, the whole was divided into 3 parts. We know that because there is 3 in the denominator. So 1 whole is equal to 3/3. As we have 2 wholes, we have to multiply the numerator by 2. And then we have to add to that 2/3. That way, we represented 2 2/3 as 8/3. Now, let's do the same with 1 1/2. Here, the whole was divided into 2 parts because there is 2 in the denominator. So 1 whole is equal to 2/2. As we have 1 whole, we have to multiply the numerator by 1. And then we have to add to that 1/2. That way, we represented 1 1/2 as 3/2. Now we have 8/3 minus 3/2. Before we subtract the numerators, we have to rewrite them one more time. As each fraction here has different denominator, we have to rewrite them as equivalent fractions with the same denominators. The least common multiple for 2 and 3 is 6. So 6 is the common denominator for 2 fractions in our example. To convert 8/3 to an equivalent fraction with 6 in the denominator, we have to multiply both denominator and numerator by 2. So 8/3 becomes 16/6. To convert 3/2 to an equivalent fraction with 6 in the denominator, we have to multiply both denominator and numerator by 3. So 3/2 becomes 9/6. Now we can subtract the numerators. So 16 minus 9 is 7. So we have 7/6, which is an improper fraction, or 1 1/6 in its simplest form. Now it's time for practice. How much is 3 4/7 minus 1 3/4? If you would like to solve this problem on your own, please pause the video and work out your answer. When ready, unpause the video to check the answer. Now, let's check the answer. As a first step, we have to represent each fraction as an improper fraction. Let's start with 3 4/7. Here, the whole was divided into 7 parts. We know that because there is 7 in the denominator. So 1 whole is equal to 7/7. As we have 3 wholes, we have to multiply the numerator by 3. And then we have to add to that 4/7. That way, we represented 3 4/7 as 25/7. Now, let's do the same with 1 3/4. Here, the whole was divided into 4 parts because there is 4 in the denominator. So 1 whole is equal to 4/4. As we have 1 whole, we have to multiply the numerator by 1. And then we have to add to that 3/4. That way, we represented 1 3/4 as 7/4. That way, we have 25/7 minus 7/4. Now, let's rewrite each fraction as an equivalent fraction with the same denominator. The least common multiple for 7 and 4 is 28. So 28 is the common denominator. To convert 25/7 to an equivalent fraction with 28 in the denominator, we have to multiply both denominator and numerator by 4. So 25/7 is 100/28. To convert 7/4 to an equivalent fraction with 28 in the denominator, we have to multiply both denominator and numerator by 7. So 7 over 4 becomes 49 over 28. Now we can subtract numerators. So 100 minus 49 is 51. So we have 51 over 28, which is an improper fraction, or 1 and 23 over 28 in the simplest form. So 3 and 4 over 7 minus 1 and 3 over 4 equals to 1 and 23 over 28.